Yesterday I finished my junior year of high school. If you saw my last video, then you know that I told you that I was going to take you through prom and getting my class ring, or my senior ring. And last Friday, a week ago, I became a senior at my school. Yesterday was probably a very emotional day, just as last Friday was. We knew that we were becoming seniors, my whole class of 2013, and we knew that we were taking on a large responsibility. This year has been a pretty emotional year for us, for my class. We watched our football team go to the state championship, although we did not win, and we were the runner-ups. It was still something that we hadn't accomplished in around 20 years. We played a tough team, a very large team, and we came pretty close to thinking that we had it. I got to see and hear all of the football players' reactions. I became friends with some of them. I helped some of them in our classes together. I got to hear their stories and what their thoughts were whenever they won the game to go to the championship, and when we came back, what they thought whenever they didn't win at championship. I think that if you're going into high school this coming year, if you're becoming a freshman or a ninth grader, or if you're another country and you're going into, I guess, the start of a newer school and you're becoming older, you should enjoy the years. For high school, at least in the US, you should appreciate the years. Do what you have to do and appreciate what you are put through. There are obstacles, but they're gonna help you. My American history teacher, who also taught me civics and economics, was my favorite teacher of 2 years. I requested her for my American history class, and I know that I'm supposed to get my report card or my final grades tomorrow or Tuesday, but it's new, because all these feelings that we're getting older, we have 1 year left, and that after that we're going to be put into a new kind of perspective. But a lot of us have experienced things in these past 3 years that will take us through some of hardships and some great things. So, prom was very interesting. It was probably one of the best years that we've had, and we sold a lot of tickets, and it was very fun. And then we got into this last month of May, and we knew finals were coming up, and that we were becoming our seniors, and we were taking the place, and that we would see some of our friends graduate. And whenever you start doing the countdown, everybody does the countdown to the end of school the first day we start, but for us to actually go through everything and then we start counting down the days to ring ceremony when we're announced as seniors. It's my senior ring. And yes, I got a heart, because, and it's not traditional or anything, it actually kind of looks like an engagement ring or a promise ring, but I can wear it forever. and kind of means to behind me getting a heart as opposed to getting a regular stone or something, a round stone or a square stone. I love my high school. My high school is a new start for me. I got to meet newer people. All the kids I went to junior high or middle school with, they all went to a high school that was closer to our middle school, and I went to one that was a little bit closer to my house. And very few from my middle school actually came with me to my high school. I remember walking on to the campus, only knowing my sister's friends, and being around her and her friends for the first week, and then her telling me that I needed to go and start finding friends of my own, and finding things that I liked. I ended up becoming friends with pretty much all of our band members of our class. I don't regret it. I will never regret it, because they are some of the best people I've met. And the fact that I have my name, my class, my graduating class, and my high school's name on this ring with a heart stone, it reminds me that I do love it. Your ring is what, it's what keeps you together. And at our ring ceremony, one of the girls on our ring committee wrote a poem about circle friends, how when we're in elementary school or in primary, that everybody, you have your circle of friends and you're always with them and you always follow them, and then when you get into middle school you may get another one, and when you're in high school you have your circle of friends, and that if you ever recognize that when you are talking to each other you're always staying in a circle so that everyone can be included. And it's very true. And that your class ring, which is a circle, it can remind you of your circle of friends and how we're all one as a graduating class. My graduating class has a little bit over 200 kids. A school in our parish, because we're in Louisiana, so we have parishes instead of counties. They had over 700 kids graduate this year. And they have a very big circle of friends. I cannot wait until next year whenever I get my diploma that says I'm out of high school and that I get to go into college. I hope that if you are going into high school, if you're in high school, enjoy the moments. Enjoy everything that comes your way, even the hardships, because you need to recognize them. What you go through, it does make you a little bit stronger. It makes you realize what you have.